Just the other day, I put out a video on the Xorg fork, XLibre, and you know what I absolutely love? I love seeing when people obviously did not watch the video, they read the title, they read the thumbnail, and thought they knew every single opinion I had in the video, who thought the video was me just gassing up XLibre, talking about how amazing it was, all this stuff. It's great. You make my day, so keep it up. I love to see it. That's not what the video was. A lot of the video was me very sort of critical of the way things are being handled in the free desktop project from both the free desktop side, but also Enrico's side as well. There were quite a few patches that were poorly tested or not really considerate of use cases that exist and still exist within the project, and were causing regressions to happen. But as very few people actually want to know the context and want to have their opinion as quickly as possible, some people were incredibly happy about the fork, other people wanted to see it removed from the face of the earth and never want to hear about it again. As for me, I will be watching the project, seeing where it goes. If anything does come out of it, hey, that's cool. But I've been daily driving Wayland anyway for... I'm sure you could find the video on my channel, probably at least 3 years at this point, somewhere in that range. Whatever happens to it doesn't really affect me anyway, so I'm just gonna watch what goes on. Now, following the banning of Enrico, all of the merge requests he still had open, everyone listed in this issue right here, click any random one of them, they have been marked as closed because the source project of this merge request has been removed. This is something that is automatically done by GitLab. There is nothing malicious being done here. But following the banning, we've had some further reverts happen as well. Now, I've seen people talking about these reverts, and I think there is some context being left out here. Some of the reverts are actually code breakages, are code regressions. Others are sort of code styling things and don't really matter that much. Like, they're functionally identical. It's just a matter of how do you want to structure the code. So let's have a look at some of them. The first one is not a code breakage, but it is still a concern nonetheless. That commit, 346D5F5C, did not handle copyright slash license notices correctly. So if we go into the changes here, we can see a bunch of things are being done, but the important part is, where is it? This right here, where he moved some stuff around and slightly modified how the copyright and license information is being displayed here. So basically, macros were moved into different files, which is not a problem in and of itself, but this did not retain the original copyright information from the person who wrote this code. Instead, it was just showing Enrico's copyright information, which shouldn't be done. You should still have the original person there. Also, with the license identifier, MIT or X11, this is supposed to say MIT and X11. This is a problem and shouldn't be like this, and any other cases like this should also be fixed, but this is not a code functionality issue. When we look at the render stuff, this is not just a single revert being done. This is actually three of them. So we have render cleanups, we have render fix RR get CRTC transform reply length, and we also have the part two of that one as well. They introduced at least this one right here, and shift render away from the dispatch vector paradigm that the rest of the X server uses. Having the sproc functions call the proc functions directly means they bypass replacement implementations of any proc functions like the ones the Nvidia driver installs, as discussed in the comments for render cleanups. Now, again, this one is actually a proper code functionality issue and did lead to a regression. This one, there's no question of whether or not this should be reverted. Now, here is my first question, and this will come up a couple of times throughout the video. There were issues raised with this back a couple of months ago. This is it before? Yes, this is before the merge was actually done. There were issues raised from the Nvidia side. why exactly was the merge gone ahead with if there were already known issues that Nvidia people like Aaron Plattner here were raising? I don't understand how that manages to go through, right? Like, I understand that this being broken, this introducing regressions is a problem, right? This is something Enrico should not have introduced. At the same time, though, some responsibility does fall onto the project and does fall onto the person who merged that code when somebody from Nvidia had issues with it. We also have another Nvidia-related revert, which Aaron Plattner has this to say on. Thanks, Alan. I have a couple of other reverts I'll need to ask for too. I'll put together an MR for those soon. Thanks. I've been working through his commits from newest to oldest, seeing which I think we should revert, but certainly don't want to revert any that break drivers and other loadable modules. However, once again, if we go back to the original merge request opened by Enrico, where the code was accepted, the code was brought into the project, why is it in German now? We're going to ignore that. If we scroll down to Aaron here, thanks for reverting those other two, but I'd like to object to marking them as deprecated. I'm generally fine with whatever ABI changes you want to make, as long as they don't prevent us from making the driver operate correctly, but we really do need this very small piece of ABI stability in order to be able to determine which ABI the driver needs to use. Now, I want to be clear, no issue with Aaron whatsoever here. Aaron is not the person who went and merged the code. Aaron is here as an Nvidia representative to raise issues regarding regressions with the Nvidia drivers, things Nvidia might need, and things of that nature. Why was it? We can talk all day about Enrico's testing, or in some cases, lack of testing, right? Like, understandable, that should be done more. But why was it that when someone directly raises issues about the merge request directly, either before or after the merge is done, why is it that no one at the time stepped back and said, maybe we should look further at this merge request and maybe it's not suitable to merge this right now? To me, what it seems like is Xorg is really lacking in testing and really lacking in quality control. It doesn't seem like there was any sort of obvious framework in place to make sure that breakages like this just don't seem to happen. And maybe something does exist, right? But whatever framework is there, there's very clearly giant gaps in it where things like this are slipping through. And it's not even like testing needed to be done here. Somebody directly raised an issue about the merge request and nobody looked at it. I don't think all the fault for the revert can just be placed on Enrico. There are clearly some policy and clearly some process issues that exist within the Xorg repo. Maybe the assumption is if you're still working on Xorg, then your code can automatically be trusted, but that clearly, you know, it doesn't really work in the real world, right? Like, no project can really work in a situation where code is not being validated before it is being merged into the project. Now, some of the reverts done are far less substantial. This one here is very much just a code styling issue. Having a macro for consistency and readability is worth it despite what the original MR said. So this is what was done. So originally there was this macro right here. We could use length rest B, which is a horrendous name, but regardless, basically, instead of having the math directly in that loop, it is split out into a macro, basically a function. Yes, macros and functions are not the same thing. I don't care right now, but basically splits it out into a separate thing that makes it reusable and makes it also a bit more readable. In the original MR, it said it's only used at exactly one place for trivial size computation, so not worth having an extra macro in a public header for this. This is also a completely understandable explanation for why you would remove it. At the same time, having the macro there does make it more readable. Does it need to be in the place where just generic macros live? I can certainly see an argument to say that no, it doesn't make sense there. Now, we also have these functions were intentionally added to a shared header so they could be used in other places where we need to avoid signed integer overflows in the future. The reason why these were moved is, pay attention to the phrasing there, could be used in other places. So as it currently stood, this function was only being used within this file. So yes, technically, it may possibly be used in other places. This is very much a code styling thing. Should this function be located in the miscellaneous file that everything can access, or should it only be in the place where it is currently being used? Should you plan for the future that may never come, or just put it in the place where it's being used and deal with it later? The code is functionally identical. There is no actual change being made here. It's entirely, where is the better place to put it? Now, the ones I'd covered so far, they'd been there for a couple of days, but as of a day ago, there have been some more reverts made as well. The first one is revert 1711. We are not going forward with Enrico's plan to clean up the wrapping jungle and are restoring the wrapping in the one area he'd removed it. Now, from what I can tell here, there is no functional difference in this code. Again, it goes back to a matter of code styling. And it's not something that the project is wanting to pursue further, because Enrico was basically the only person going down this route. It was basically cleaning up the way the function calls are done, rather than having really long chains, which seemed kind of excessive. We have revert 1681. Again, no core functionality change being made here, but it did create some very minor ABI changes, and I guess they wanted to revert that and go back to what was being done previously. We have revert 1519. This complicates extension handling with modules for no good reason. So here are the changes specifically. When the GitLab wants to load, this might be my connection actually. Welcome to Australia. Basically, it's just removing a bunch of Boolean statements that are checking if something is enabled or disabled. That's, for the most part, what's being done here. We also have revert parts of 1591. Specifically, I kept these two here. 37DD2897 and FDB8C8EA. The first seems like a reasonable improvement, and the second seems like a correct bug fix. I reverted these two, though. The first switches away from the model used in the rest of the X server that allows replacing functions but is changing pointers in the dispatch table when needed, and the second replaces explicit calls with implicit behavior, making it harder for humans to see what values are being set, even if the compiler can optimize out the explicit settings on its own. Now, going forward, we'll see if more reverts are being made, and we'll see how many of those reverts are actual, real changes to the code, and how many of them are, we didn't check the code styling, or there was already somebody who had an issue with it, and nobody read the issue, I guess. I still don't know how those managed to slip through, right? Like, it's not like there's so much activity in Xorg that you're gonna miss a comment being made. So I don't really get how somebody from Nvidia has a direct concern and you still go ahead and merge it anyway. We'll see what happens going forward, right? Yes, I could say, oh, it's gonna be dead tomorrow. It's gonna be dead next week. The project's not gonna matter. I don't have a time machine. I don't know what's gonna happen. It might live on, it might become a niche thing, it might just die next week. I don't know, but I will be keeping an eye on it. So, if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you wanna see more that's going on in this space, let me know, I'm happy to talk about it. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, and Iberapay linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and Are you truly Libre? We'll be right back.